there hasn't been much, if any, really, discussion here at YouTube about one of Lovecraft's primary income sources, and that was his role in revising and, in many cases, rewriting or completely writing the fiction of clients who sent their work to him or a plot outline and then paid him to either revise or write their stories. In most cases, in all cases that I know of, Lovecraft did not sign his name to these stories, and when they were published in Weird Tales or wherever, they were published only with Lovecraft's name missing. It was Zelia Bishop, Hazel Heald, and others. The stories were published under their byline, and they got most of the money from that Weird Tales sale. And it's funny because in the letter columns of Weird Tales, so I've been reading the letters from Weird Tales in A Writer in Our Mists, Early Criticism of H.P. Lovecraft, edited by S.T. Joshi for Hippocampus Press. And some of the letters printed here are from fans who had no clue that these stories that sounded so much like the work of H.P. Lovecraft were indeed the writing of H.P. Lovecraft. And in his introduction, S.T. has a lovely little bit which kind of he's being a bit of a snob, but I love it when S.T.'s a literary snob. Let's see. And yet, I suspect that both Wright, Farnsworth Wright, who was the editor of Weird Tales, and Lovecraft gained a certain wry amusement when readers found merits in tales that Lovecraft had ghostwritten. The most priceless comment from this perspective is Bernard J. Kenton's remark on Hazel Heald's The Horror in the Museum, which Lovecraft surely wrote from beginning to end. Quote, even Lovecraft, as powerful and artistic as he is with a macabre suggestiveness, could hardly, I suspect, have surpassed the grotesque scene in which the other dimensional scrambler leaps out upon the hero. Let it pass that this scene, as with the story as a whole, was probably meant as a parody. Kenton, the future creator of Superman, was not likely to appreciate such subtleties. Ooh, honey. Meow. but it's just really fun to read some of these letters that were published in Weird Tales and that are reprinted in this book. John Malone of Jackson, Mississippi writes, how does Hazel Heald do it? Out of the Eons is like a masterpiece by H.P. Lovecraft. Hardly any of the horror was pictured. Most of it was suggested until the climax, when the revelation came! Exclamation mark. Out of the Eons was the most remarkable, the best, the greatest at all narrative it has been my good fortune to read in Weird Tales. It seems you have that indefinable something that science fiction has been lacking. Yours for more, Hazel Heald. The April number was a treat. I cannot say enough in praise of the work of Hazel Heald. She is a veritable female Lovecraft, her Out of the Eons, is a masterpiece. I almost expected that Mr. Lovecraft himself would stroll into the museum and take a hand at deciphering the hieroglyphics on the scrollen cylinder. Let's have more. And on and on and on. Quite amusing. This is the Arkham House edition. This is actually one of the dust jackets by, this dust jacket painting is by Tony Patrick. I really hate the other jackets that Tony Patrick has done for Arkham House. I just think they're bloody awful. But I do like this one, so I bought this edition of the hardcover. This is a collection of the revisions by H.P. Lovecraft. And they are divided into what S.T. calls primary revisions. And then secondary revisions. And this, there was an earlier version of this book published by Derleth in the 1970s, I believe. This is the corrected text where S.T. Joshi has gone back and corrected the mistakes found in that edition. It has been reprinted in the Del Rey trade paperback series with an introduction by Stephen Jones. Stephen Jones is, of course, one of the finest British editors of the genre. So, that has a really wonderful jacket illustration. That's just magnificent. And here's a page of H.P. Lovecraft's revision of a story. The revisions are interesting. Some of them do indeed. S.T. Joshi said that the horror in the museum reads like a parody. Actually, it reads like pulp fiction. And I've been pretty insistent in the fact that Lovecraft did not write pulp fiction. If sometimes elements of the pulp fiction genre crept into his fiction, he always regretted that fact. He was trying to write literature. He thought of his writing as a form of literary art. And in most cases, you know, he was successful. There are some of the revision stories, though, and in particular, for me, is the horror in the museum, which is so corny, so overwritten, so badly written, that you just cannot believe that Lovecraft is being serious when he wrote this. And it's almost like he knew that the story was not going to be printed with his name in the byline. But one of the interesting things he did was he made these stories very Cthulhu mytho-ish. In fact, these stories are very close to some of the things that August Derleth did when Derleth became obsessed with writing his tales of Cthulhu mythos. I just want to read this one paragraph from the horror in the museum. You just cannot. I mean, this is not Lovecraft being serious. Jones' fainting spell could not have lasted more than a moment, for the nameless thing was apishly dragging him through the darkness when he began recovering consciousness. What started him fully awake were the sounds which the thing was making, or rather, the voice with which it was making them. That voice was human, and it was familiar. Only one living being could be behind that hoarse, feverish accents which were chanting to the unknown horror. "Ea! Ea!" it was howling. "I am coming, O Ra Togoth! Coming with the nourishment! You have waited long and fed ill, but now you shall have what was promised, that and more, for instead of Orobona, it will be one of the high degree who has doubted you. You shall crush and drain him with all his doubts, and grow strong thereby. And even after among men, he shall be shewn as a monument to your glory. Ran Togoth, infinite and invincible, I am your slave and high priest. You are hungry, and I provide. I read the sign and have led you forth. I shall feed you with blood, and you shall feed me with power. Ea, Shub-Niggurath, the goat with a thousand young." On and on and on. That's Cthulhu Mythos Claptrap. And I simply cannot take that story seriously under any means. It's a very silly story, overwritten, not very, well, I don't know if it was, I don't know how to gauge its originality, considering the time that it was written. It was written before there was actually such a thing as the Cthulhu Mythos tradition. I just said Cthulhu. Oh, I can't believe I said Cthulhu. S.T. Joshi has taught me it's not Cthulhu, it's Cthulhu. 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 Not Cthulhu. Cthulhu. The Cthulhu Mythos. So, this is a lovely collection. It's got some very good stories, and as the title story, some very silly stories. The S.T. Joshi has just re-edited for Arcane Wisdom Press a two-volume edition of the revisions. I believe it is called The Crawling Chaos and Others. Two hardcover editions, each of which will sell for $50, and these will be fully annotated editions of the stories. And I really look forward to reading that. And when those volumes are published, I shall do a story-by-story commentary here at YouTube on those stories which I find the most interesting. I'm obviously not doing a complete commentary on all of Lovecraft's fiction, because some of the stories just really bore me, and I ain't got nothing to say about those, love. Alright. So, you can find the horror in the museum, in the trade paperback, at Amazon and Abe's Books online. And I recommend it. It's most of the writing that is good in that collection is the writing of H.P. Lovecraft. Some of the stories, such as the huge novelette The Mound, are indeed very important works in the Lovecraft canon. So I recommend The Horror in the Museum. And again, those stories will be reprinted in a two-volume annotated set called The Crawling Chaos and Others, edited and annotated by S.T. Joshi for Arcane Wisdom Press. Shalom, my darlings.